This device claims it can help you save up to 90% on your electricity bill. Oh look, and it claims to be fireproof? Yeah, I'm sure that's gonna work out very well. Sponsored by Linode. Hey guys, how are you all doing? If you're new here, welcome. My name is Krazy Ken, and excuse me, Krazy Ken, but Big Clive, Electro Boom, and other creators have already covered this product. Whoa, whoa, whoa there, keyboard warrior, take a chill pill. You're right, other creators have done a great job covering this scam product, but only I can bring the Krazy Ken experience to the table. I've received many requests to take a look at this product, and I was in another person's lair recently, and guess what? They had this product plugged into their wall. So this scam is still rampant, and it can trick people, so we need to dive into this product today. And I gotta tell ya, it's been a while since my bull detector has been this high. There is so much wrong with this product and the claims surrounding it. So we'll take a look at how electricity works, and more importantly, how this thing doesn't work. And we're gonna start with the websites. I've seen 4 different websites for this product, though I'm sure there's many more. And each website refers to this product by a different name. And the product looks similar on all websites, except for this eSaver website, where the casing looks a little bit different. For the most part, these web pages are shoddily put together, but this EcoChamp page actually looks really good. But don't be deceived by a pretty website. All of these pages make similar claims, and they're talking about the same product. And this thing is still 100% a scam. So let's take a closer look at this EcoServe site. This site claims the device can help you save up to 90% on your electricity bill, and it's easy to install. Just plug it in. And it claims this gadget was initially created by Nikola Tesla. Oh sure, let's just look up EcoServe on the Nikola Tesla fan wiki. Oh look, nothing! Anyway, they claim our household devices use more energy than needed to run because of the amount of noise on the sine wave it produces, making it inefficient. And they show these before and after graphs, which appear to be alternating current sine waves, and we'll talk more about that technical stuff in a bit. Moving on, the site also says if you use multiples of this device in your home, you can reach EcoServe's maximum potential. Hey, that's a great way to trick people into buying more of your product! Genius! Actually, wait a minute. If you buy enough and you plug them into all the outlets in your home, you won't have any outlets left to plug stuff into. That actually would save a lot of electricity. Wow! This thing actually may not be that bad! This Want Rescue site looks super sketchy with some more clickbaity links at the bottom. And an incredibly annoying bouncing Apple Pay button. My favorite part is the customer reviews because there's actually some complaints with 1-star ratings. So maybe these reviews actually aren't fake, which is weird because in a lot of my scam busting investigations, the reviews look pretty fake. They also use a fake countdown timer to make it look like a sale is ending soon, but like I've mentioned before, that's just a scarcity marketing tactic that entices you to buy because it gives you a sense of urgency, when in reality, the countdown timer is just gonna reset and that discount is very likely never gonna expire. Again, you'll notice similar claims among the pages, but you'll also see inconsistencies. For example, EcoChamp claims a 50% savings, whereas EcoServe claims 90%. And as for pricing, EcoChamp is $49, Watt Rescue is $24.99, EcoServe is $34.95, and eSaver is $44.90. Now, to give you some perspective on how cheap this product really is, if you take a look at them on AliExpress, you'll see that they sell for about $1.15 each. And keep in mind, the seller has to make a profit on that $1.15, which means before the markup, the total cost of the components inside this thing is really frickin' low. And that should give you a hint about the type of quality that is in this product. And if you search electricity saving box on AliExpress, you'll see a lot of products that look just like this. So it's safe to say this thing is a pile of crap, and it doesn't work, but it's always very fun to see how poorly it works, right? That's the best part. So, we'll test it out. But first, let's talk about how electricity actually gets to your home, and we'll also talk about power factor. Electric current is delivered to your house from a power plant through a series of lines, transformers, and substations. There's 2 types of current: alternating current, AC, and direct current, DC. Direct current travels one way, and is used in devices like your phone. This type of current is how the battery powers your phone's electric components. Alternating current moves back and forth. This type of current is used for delivering electrical power to your house, because AC helps the electricity travel long distances. Alternating current flows forward and backward, in sync with the rotation of a magnet inside a generator. in this case. And if we plot the rotation of the magnet, which correlates to the intensity of the voltage, we get a sine wave, similar to what the websites show. And this is what you would see on an oscilloscope. As the magnet gets closer to the coils in the generator, voltage is increased until max intensity is reached. Then the voltage will decrease as the magnet passes the coil, and it will eventually hit zero. Then as the opposite side of the magnet spins toward the coil, the flow is reversed. And this cycle occurs 60 times per second in America. Depending on where you live, AC may move back and forth 50 times per second as opposed to 60. And we measure these movements with hertz. It's just a short way of saying blank per second. So in this case, 60 hertz is 60 oscillations of alternating current per second. Alternating current is what your home's electrical outlets use. In fact, many of your appliances will use it. Your lights, for example, even though it looks like your lights are giving off a constant brightness level, they're actually going bright and dark and bright and dark really, really fast due to the alternating current. You just can't see it because your eye can't perceive how fast the light is changing. But for fun, take your phone and go film a light in your house with the slow motion feature, and then play that video back in slow motion, and you will see the light flickering. Pretty neat, huh? Now, the website showed those two sine waves on that graph, so what are they hinting at here? Well, realistically, it's just their marketing BS trying to sound scientific and smart. But there actually might be a hint of real science in here. And that's where power factor correction comes in. Power factor represents the ratio between true power, how much power is doing real work, versus apparent power, how much power is actually being used, even if it's waste. And it ranges from -1 to 1. 1 being perfect, indicating there's no wasted power, and potentially no wasted money. To visualize this easier, we'll use the classic beer analogy, where apparent power is the whole glass, which you pay for, and the beer is true power, the useful stuff, the stuff you actually want to drink. And the foam is the reactive power, which is the useless stuff, the stuff you don't want to drink. Although in real life, a little bit of head in a beer is a good thing because of the aroma, but you know what I'm trying to say. So in commercial environments, like a large factory, for example, power companies will typically bill those facilities for all of that power being used, even if some of that power is not doing any work. Because still, it's power that is being supplied from the power company, and they want their money. So the factory in this example can use a capacitor on all of their large motors to help bring that power factor closer to 1, which can potentially save money. And here's how that works. There's two types of AC power, real or active power, and reactive power. In real or active power, voltage and current are in phase. In other words, all the electricity is doing the work. For example, generating heat in an electric heater. Here, the power factor is 1. But voltage and current can be moved out of phase. For example, in an inductive load. An inductive load converts current into a magnetic field, which can be used to spin the giant motors in this factory scenario. So in this example, the current lags the voltage, and that consequently generates reactive power. It may appear wasteful because that power is not doing any real work, but it is necessary to create and maintain the magnetic field, so the motor can spin. And capacitors can correct the power factor and realign the current back into phase so the factory doesn't get billed for that excess wasted power, or reactive power, when operating this large machinery. I talk more about capacitors in my 8-Bit Guy collab episode, so definitely check that out. So yes, capacitors can help save money in these larger commercial settings. And it seems like these scam marketers are trying to take that science and repackage it for consumers. But in reality, does this idea really save you money in a residential context? No! Power companies in a residential setting don't charge for apparent power because there's not much wasted or reactive power in the first place, so they don't even bother. And your power meter probably doesn't have the apparatus to display apparent power and reactive power usage in the first place. It displays the kilowatt hours, which is what you actually get billed for. So the only way this electricity saving box could actually save you power and money is if somehow there was some sort of computer or smart brains inside of this thing to somehow control the power in your home. So to see if that's the case, we're gonna need to open one up. So you guessed it, I went ahead and bought one. Just kidding. I bought 2! You know, so I could plug 2 of them in and save more energy. The box claims this device is intelligent and digital, and it makes more claims about saving electricity and money. You can also reduce the electric appliance getting fever. Oh yeah, that's a serious illness. Be careful with that. They actually do mention power factor on the packaging, which I thought was interesting. But again, that doesn't apply to a residential area because you don't get billed for apparent power, and that's different from true power. But they're probably betting on the fact that consumers don't know the difference between the two. And frankly, that's a pretty safe bet. Funny enough, on the back it says Electricity Saving Spikes Buster. Spikes Buster, I guess that was the original name for the product? And the label on the front of it says Electricity Saving Box, Intelligent Energy Saver. Somehow I doubt that. But don't worry, the result is the best. So now let's tear open this bad boy and see what mystical magic lies within. Ready? All right, done. Guess we can take a look at it now. The inner construction of this product is insanely bad, and the plastic is molded poorly. Circuit-wise, there's a small PCB with two LEDs and four resistors, which are likely present to protect the LEDs, but they may serve some other mysterious function I'm not aware of. There's also a black box wired to the board. Ooh, this looks so mysterious, like one of those monoliths from Space Odyssey, just really tiny. Does this thing hold the brains? The brains that will control your home and save all that electricity for you? No, it's a capacitor. Whoop-de-doo. I'm not as ballsy as Electro Boom, so I won't measure the current change in my breaker box with the energy saver attached. But in his tests, the highest current drop he experienced was only 100 milliamps, which is very insignificant, and that won't save you much power or money at all. And if it could save you any power, it's only gonna save you reactive power, which again, doesn't apply to a residential scenario because you're not billed for that power in the first place. And appliances, like your refrigerator, that use alternating current to power the motors, likely already have a capacitor in them to increase their power factor anyway, so this thing is really, really pointless! And also, there's no integrated circuits or processors or any other components that hint at any sort of intelligent tasks being carried out by this product. So, with all the BS and the cool science stuff aside, let's test this out in a real-world scenario and see if we can get that 50% savings, let alone 90%. Now, to measure my layer's energy consumption, I installed a sense monitor into my box, and it transmits real-time watt usage to the cloud. When I plugged the two electricity-saving boxes in, I noticed no difference in watt consumption, and therefore, no difference in potential energy savings. I left the boxes plugged in for 8 days, and I checked my usage reports, and I noticed nothing different from the norm. Fluctuations in watt usage will occur, especially depending on the weather, if I need to run the heater more or maybe the air conditioner more, but everything else I have runs on a pretty routine schedule. So if we were truly getting a 50% or a 90% savings in watt usage, we would see a dramatic change in the graphs, but none of that happened. By the way, if you do want to get your own Sense monitor, you can click my affiliate link down in the description. They're really freaking cool, and it's just a one-time purchase. There's no subscription required. So this data helps us conclude that this electricity saving box is just a pile of garbage. But we kind of knew that from the beginning. But again, it's really fun to see just how garbage these things are. But do you know what's not a pile of garbage? Linode! These guys have data centers all over the world, and could you imagine the energy bill for places like that? Thankfully, you don't have to worry about that because Linode takes care of that for you. If you have an application or website that you need to deploy and scale, Linode has the infrastructure and the 24/7 support in place for you. Linode offers out-of-box apps for game servers like TF2, CSGO, and even Minecraft. You can run your own virtual private network with OpenVPN, build an online application with Joomla's content management system, or build a video streaming site with a multitude of app choices. There's so much you can do with Linode's affordable Linux virtual machines. And to boot, they offer award-winning 24/7 technical support. To put it simply, if it runs on Linux, it runs on Linode. Visit linode.com/computerclan and click the Create Free Account button. And when you do that, I'll give you a 60-day $100 credit just for watching this episode. And also, you'll be supporting the Computer Clan, so thank you very much. So now for the final test, we're gonna see how fireproof this thing really is. Remember Crazy Carl? He's my guy I go to when I need some cool tools. In this case, a blowtorch. So let's go pay him a visit and see if this thing can take the heat. So today, I'm going to show you how to make scam cakes. So take your scam product and with a blowtorch, just lightly sear that edge, yeah? Just get a nice yummy brownness there. Oh sh**. Well, let's just call it creme brulee. Yeah, I don't know. Is it fireproof? Audience, what do you think? So that's the electricity saving box. Frankly, it doesn't save anything. In fact, it does the opposite. It wastes your money and it's just gonna end up in a landfill. pretty sad. But hey, at least the ridiculous scams stop there, right? There's not anything else crazy out there, like what's next, a magical device that saves you gas in your car? That couldn't happen, right? That couldn't happen, right? It couldn't happen, right?